hands towards me. आप लोग सब मेरी ओर इस तरह से हाथ रखिए, अतः डोले भी टूट गया. प्लीज क्लोज योर आईज, आंखें बंद कर लीजिए. और संतुलन के लिए सबसे पहले आप हमारी ओर, मैं अंग्रेजी में कहूंगी, लेफ्ट हैंड करिए और राइट हैंड जमीन पर रखिए. प्लीज पुट योर लेफ्ट हैंड टुवर्ड्स मी एंड राइट हैंड ऑन द मदर अर्थ फॉर द बैलेंस. डावा हात माझ्याकडे करायचा आणि उजवा हात जमिनीवर ठेवायचा. संतुलनासाठी धर्माचा सर्वसार हेच आहे, आपल्यात संतुलन नाही. आणि संतुलनासाठी डावा हात माझ्याकडे आणि उजवा हात जमिनीकडे करायचा. लेफ्ट हैंड ऊपर की ओर, उजवा हाथ माझ्याकडे आणि डावा हाथ वर.
Thank you.
द हैंड फोर्स रेस्ट देम ऑन योर लैप. आपल्या मांडीवर आरामात दोन्ही हात असे ठेवून
Thank you. गणेश अथर्व शीर्ष।
ॐ नमस्ते गणपतये त्वमेव प्रत्यक्षं तत्त्वमसि त्वमेव केवलं करतासि त्वमेव केवलं धरतासि त्वमेव केवलं हरतासि त्वमेव सर्वं खल्विदं ब्रह्मासि त्वं साक्षादात्मासि नित्यं हृतं वच्मि सत्यं वच्मि अवत्वं माम् अववक्तारम् अवश्रोतारम् अवदातारम् अवधातारम् अवानुं च नमवशिष्यम् अवपश्चात्तात् अवपुरस्तात् अवोत्तरात्तात् अवदक्षिणात्तात् अवचोर्ध्वात्तात् अवाधरात्तात् सर्वतो मां पाहि पाहि समन्तात् त्वं वाङ्मयस्त्वं चिन्मयः त्वं आनन्दमयस्त्वं ब्रह्ममयः त्वं सच्चिदानन्दाद्वितीयोऽसि त्वं प्रत्यक्षं ब्रह्मासि त्वं ज्ञानमयो विज्ञानमयोऽसि सर्वं जगदिदं त्वत्तो जायते सर्वं जगदिदं त्वत्तस्तिष्ठति सर्वं जगदिदं त्वयि लयमिष्यति सर्वं जगदिदं त्वयि प्रत्येति त्वं भूमिरापो नलो नीलो नभः त्वं चत्वारि वाक् पदानि त्वं गुणत्रयातीतः त्वं देहत्रयातीतः त्वं कालत्रयातीतः त्वं मूलाधारस्थितोऽसि नित्यं त्वं शक्तित्रयात्मकः त्वां योगिनो ध्यायन्ति नित्यम् त्वं ब्रह्मा त्वं विष्णुस्त्वं रुद्रस्त्वं इन्द्रस्त्वं अग्निस्त्वं वायुस्त्वं सूर्यस्त्वं चन्द्रमास्त्वं ब्रह्मभूर्भुवः स्वरों गणादीं पूर्वमुच्चार्य वर्णादीं तदनन्तरम् अनुस्वारः परतरः अरधेन्दुलसितं तारेण हृद्गम् एतत्तवमनुस्वरूपं गकारः पूर्वरूपम् अकारो मध्यमरूपम् अनुस्वारश्चान्त्यरूपम् बिन्दुरुत्तररूपम् नादः सन्धानम् संहितासन्धिः सैषा गणेशविद्या गणकऋषिः निचृद्गायत्री छन्दः गणपतीर्देवता ॐ गं गणपतये नमः एकदन्ताय विद्महे वक्रतुण्डाय धीमहि तन्नो दन्ती प्रचोदयात् एकदन्तं चतुर्हस्तं पाशमङ्कुशधारिणं रदं च वरदं हस्तैर्बिभ्राणं मूषकध्वजं रक्तं लम्बोदरं शूर्पकर्णकम् रक्तवाससम् रक्तगन्धानुलिप्ताङ्गम् रक्तपुष्पैः सुभोजितम् भक्ताङ्कम्पिनम् देवम् जगत्कारणमच्युतम् आविर्भूतम् च सृष्ट्यादौ प्रकृतेः पुरुषात् परम् एवं ध्यायति यो नित्यम् स योगी योगिनां वरः नमो व्रातपतये नमो गणपतये नमः प्रमथपतये नमस्ते अस्तु लंबोदरायैकदन्ताय विघ्ननाशिने शिवसुताय श्रीवरदमूर्तये नमो नमः साक्षात् श्री आदिशक्ति माताजि श्री निर्मला देव्याय नमो नमः।
जय श्री माताजी एवरीवन, नमस्कार। रेज योर कुंडलिनी एंड टेक बंडल। Now, fix the red dot on Marvel photograph and slowly close your eye and take deep respiration 3 times. Affirmation, Mother, please give us the permission to do this meditation. We will meditate on 4 petals of Muladhara Chakra. Take 1 time the mantra of Sri Ganesha. Om Twamiva Shashat Sri Ganesha Shashat Sri Adishati Mataji Sri Nivana Devi Namo Namah. Now, the first petal goes in a downward direction toward the ground. Affirmation, Mother, please bless us with the joy of Brahmanand. Stay a few times in meditation. Now, we have the second petal, which goes toward the left. Here we have 2 affirmations. First affirmation, Mother, please, yet let your Sri Ganesha Tattwa remove all the obstacles to our ascent. Stay a few times in meditation. The second affirmation, Mother, please fill each cell of our being with the majesty and dignity of the pure spirit. Stay a few times in meditation. Now, we have a third petal which goes toward, which goes to the right. Here, we have three affirmations. First affirmation, Mother, please fill every cell of all being by the complete dedication and surrender of Sri Ganesha to your holy lotus feet. Stay few time in meditation. Second affirmation, Mother, please bless us with the joy, with the absolute wisdom of your Sri Ganesh. Stay few time in meditation. The third affirmation, Mother, please bless us with the pure knowledge of your divinity, of your divinity. Say few time in meditation. Now, we have a fourth petal which goes upward. Here we have two affirmations. The first affirmation, Shri Mataji, please bless us with the complete fearlessness of your Sri Ganesha. Stay few time meditation. The second affirmation, Mother, please fill each and every cell of all being with the nectar of your divine love. Stay few time meditation. Jai Shri Ganesha, Jai Shri Mataji. Now, we will listen a raga for Muladhara Chakra. Thank you. Jai Shri Mataji. Mahavir, thank you for this meditation. Jai Shri Mataji.
Today we are doing a special type of puja which is performed in the glory of Ekadasha Rudra. Rudra is the destructive power of Shiva, of the spirit. Now one power which is his nature is forgiveness. He forgives because we are human beings, we commit mistakes, we do wrong things, we get tempted, our attention is disturbed, so he forgives us. He also forgives us when we spoil our chastity, we do immoral things, we do thieving, and we do things that are against God, talk against Him. He also forgives our superficialities, jealousies, our lust, our anger. Also He forgives our attachments, petty jealousies, vanities, and also possessiveness. He forgives our egotistical behavior and also our subordination to wrong things. But every action has a reaction. And when He forgives, He thinks that He has given you a big grace mark. And that reaction builds up within him as a wrath against those who are forgiven, try to do greater mistakes, especially after realization. Because such a big blessing there is of the realization, you've got the light, and in the light, if you are holding on to a snake, then his wrath goes up because he sees how stupid you have been. What I'm saying is that after realization especially, he is much more sensitive that people who are forgiven and have been given such a big thing like self-realization, still they do wrong things, then he is much more wrathful. So in the balance, the forgiveness starts reducing and wrathfulness starts increasing. But when he forgives, and as a result of that forgiveness, you feel the gratitude, then his blessings start flowing towards you. He gives you tremendous capacity to forgive others. He pacifies your anger, He pacifies your lust, He pacifies your greed. Like beautiful dewdrop, His blessings come on our being and we become really beautiful flowers. And we start shining in the sunshine of His blessings. Now He uses His wrath or his destructive power to destroy all that tries to trouble us. He protects realized souls at every point, in every way. Negative forces try to attack a Sahayogi, but they are all neutralized by his tremendous power of protection. Through his vibratory awareness, we are guided into right path. All the beautiful blessings of his are described in the Psalm 23, isn't it? That's the 23 Psalm.
The Lord is my shepherd.
Is all described how he looks after you like a shepherd. But he does not look after the evil people. He destroys them. Those who enter into Sahaja Yoga are still carrying on with their evil nature are destroyed. Those who come to Sahaja Yoga and do not meditate and do not fight, he destroys. Or they are thrown out of Sahaja Yoga. Those who murmur against God and live in a way that is not behoving a Sahaja Yogi, he removes them from. So by one force he protects, by another force he throws away. But his destructive forces, when they are built up too much, then we call it now the Ekadasha Rudra is active. Now this Ekadasha Rudra will be expressed when the Kalaki itself will start acting, means the destructive power which will destroy all that is negative on this earth and save all that is positive. So it is very necessary for Sahaja Yogis to expedite their ascent, not to be satisfied with the social life or married life or with all the blessings that God has bestowed upon. We always see what God has done for us, how He has been miraculous to us, but we have to see what we have done to ourselves. What are we doing about our own ascent and growth? Now out of the 11, Ekadasha means 11, the 5 come from the right side of your void, and 5 from the left side of your void. The first 5 on the left hand side come from if you have bowed yourself to wrong gurus, or if you have read wrong books, or if you have been in the company of wrong people, or if you have been sympathetic towards people who have been following wrong paths, or you have been yourself one of the agents or guru of these wrong people. Now these 5 problems can be solved if we completely give up whatever wrong we have been doing. As Muhammad Sahib has said that you have to beat the shaitan, means the satan, with truth. But that has to be done not mechanically, but from your heart. Like many people who come to Sahaja will tell me, my father is following this guru, that father is following that guru, and get involved with their father, mother, sister, this, that, and try to take them out from those gurus, also get entangled. Or some of them yield to others' forces. Like I know of Maureen, who was with me, and her parents and parents-in-law said that the child must be baptized. I told her, you cannot get this child baptized because the realized soul. But she could not that way stand up to them, and she took the child for baptism, and the child became very funny. It was little like a mad child. Now she gave up all that, and so she has saved. But supposing she had another child, she would have done the same thing. The second child would have been something very, very bad. Now the trouble with Sahaja Yogis is that
Anybody who comes to Sahaja Yoga program thinks he is a Sahaja Yogi. It's not so. Either you should have very strong sensitivity, or you should feel it in your body, or with your intelligence you should understand what is Sahaja Yoga. A person who is still negative always gets attracted towards another one who is a very, very powerfully negative, and does not understand that the other person is so powerfully negative, but gets impressed. Under such circumstances, such a person is hit by that negative person, and Shiva cannot protect. One should not have sympathy with anyone who is negative, whether he is mad, whether there is something wrong with him, whether he is your relation or anything. No sympathy of any kind. On the contrary, a kind of a anger should be there for that person. Kind of a detachment, angry detachment. And this angry detachment is the only time when you have to be angry. But I have seen people who have anger for very good Sahaja Yogis, but not for their own husband or wives, who are extremely negative. So when the Ekadasha Rudra starts acting on these five sides, on the we should say on the right side it moves, because it comes from the left and moves to the right side, then a person starts becoming negative but acting with his ego. Such a person may take up a situation into hands and say that I am such and such Sahaja Yogi, and I am so, and we should do like this, and we should behave like this, and start dictating people, can do anything. And some mediocres or some half-baked Sahaja Yogis may try to understand, but most of them will know that this fellow is going out now, he's on his way out. So all these things lead to this left side development, or we can call it on the head, on the right hand side of your medha. This plate, brain plate, is called as medha in Sanskrit language. Now the right sided one comes from the idea people have that I am myself a big guru. They start preaching about Sahaja Yoga also as if they have become great gurus. We have known some people who give big lectures in any program and never allow my tape to be played or anything. They think they have now become experts. Then some of them say that now we have become so great that we need not do any foot soaking or anything, there's no need to do meditation. There are some like that also. And then there are some who say that sin can never touch us, now we are Sahaja Yogis, we are very great evolved souls. But the worst of all are those who just take my name, saying that mother has said so, and I'm telling you because mother has said, when I've never said such a thing. It's all falsehood. Now there are some people who use Sahaja Yoga money and exploit Sahaja Yoga in such a way, exploit them. Sahaja Yogis also sometimes. And such people become very inauspicious. Anyone who tries such things will go out of Sahaja Yoga with disgrace. But one should never go near such a person, have nothing to do with such a person, have no sympathies. Because this inauspiciousness will hurt anyone to any extent, so better keep out of such people. When these 10 Ekadashas are developed within a person, then definitely such a person gets diseases like cancer and incurable, horrible diseases. Especially when the 11th one, which is actually here, which is the Virata's chakra, which is the collectivity, when it is affected as well, then such a person cannot get out of this disease. But these, out of these, even five are combined, supposing, with Muladhara or with Agya, then they get into very serious type of dirty diseases. That's why I always say that be careful about your Agya Chakra, because that is one of the worst thing that once it starts getting combined with these Ekadashas, part of the Ekadashas, then anything can happen to a person. He can meet with a horrible accident, he can suddenly be hit by someone, could be murdered by someone, anything can happen to such a person who has got the right Agya, and also any one of the Ekadashas, right or left. That means the five of these, any one of the fives, if they combine with Agya Chakra, the protective power of God are minimum. So to keep your Agya Chakra, right, see now I'm speaking, now you should watch me constantly so that there is thoughtless awareness and the Agya Chakra is soothed out. But don't pay attention here and there all the time. Then you will find that gradually your attention will neutralize into thoughtless awareness.
Yeah.
And your attention would be fixed in such a manner that you don't have to worry about anything. In thoughtless awareness, nobody can touch you. That's your fortress. By meditation, one must establish thoughtless awareness. That is the sign that you are rising higher. Many people do meditation and say, all right, Mother, we are doing mechanically, they do. And they say, yes, I did this, I did this, I did this. But did you achieve your thoughtless awareness minimum of minimum? Otherwise, if you are doing something mechanically, it is not going to help you or help anyone. So after realization, as you are very well protected, you have all the blessings and a great future, you also have a great possibility of a complete annihilation. I would say, to give an analogy, you are climbing and everybody is supporting you to climb, holding your hand, and there are so many things by which you are protected to be taken upward. There is no possibility of falling off by mistake also. But if you try to remove your bondages with truth and love, and all the time try to hit the people who are trying to support you, then you fall from a great height. Greater height. I mean, the greater height you rise, the greater you fall. And with a greater force also, much go deeper. But every effort is made by the Divine, every support is given to you, every care is taken. Despite that, if you want to fall, then from that height is very dangerous. But Ekadasha Rudra at that time, at such a time, when somebody tries to harm the cause of Sahaja Yoga after being in Sahaja Yoga, then hits you so badly that the whole attack is very widespread. But the whole family can be protected if there are few people of that family doing Sahaja Yoga work, could be protected. But in case the family that is against all the time of Sahaja Yogis and try to trouble them, can be completely destroyed in a very bad way. Now these Ekadasha Rudras come out of, as I told you, from the void. So we can say that the destruction part of it comes from the void mainly. But these are the powers, all are given in one person, that is the Mahavishnu, that is Lord Jesus Christ. Because he is the support of the whole universe. He is the personification of Omkara, he is the personification of vibrations. So when he gets angry, then the whole universe starts breaking. As he personifies the power of the mother, which is penetrating into every atom, into every molecule, and to every human being, into every that is living and non-living. Once it gets disturbed, the whole thing gets into jeopardy. So the pleasing of Christ is very important. Now Christ has said, you have to be like small children. That is the innocence, the purity of heart is the best way you can please. As in the West especially, people have developed their brains too much. They try to play about with words and think that nobody knows what they are doing. All such people must know that everything you do is known to God. If you are not clean in your heart, it is very dangerous for anybody to pose as if he is a very good surgeon. Such people are not possessed, nor they are conditioned, nor they are egoistical, but they are very cunning, clever people, and they are quite aware as to what they are doing. But there are people who get possessed also, and then they try to destroy themselves or cry and weep and do all kinds of things. There are some who think that if they hurt themselves or do some sort of an extreme thing, then God will be happy, are sadly mistaken. If you cannot enjoy in Sahaja Yoga, then you should know there's something wrong with you. If you cannot feel happy in Sahaja Yoga, then you must know there's something definitely wrong with you. If you cannot enjoy the company of such yogis, then be sure something wrong with you. If you cannot laugh and appreciate the greatness of God, then it's something wrong with you. If you are still worried about negative people and their problems, then know that there's something wrong. If you have sympathies with negative people, then also there's something wrong with you. But if you have anger for negative and all that is negative, that is against Sahaja Yoga, then you are there. When this thing gets mature, then you become the power of Ekadashi Rudra yourself. Anybody who will try to insult you or to do any harm will collapse. It has happened with many people who tried to be insulting to me or tried to harm me or anyway. Sometimes I'm quite worried about them. So one has to be in such a way that they become the Ekadashi. Nobody can touch such people. But such a person is full of compassion and forgiveness. As a result, Ekadasha acts much faster. The more compassionate you are, the more powerful Ekadasha becomes. The more collective you become, the more Ekadasha acts. Many people have a habit of receding back into their exclusion and saying that, oh, we
better be at home and it's all right. But they don't know what they are missing. Whatever may be your experience with others, you should stick on together, always attend programs, take leadership, go ahead with it, work it out, and you will be blessed thousandfold. Ekadasha Rudra are all the powers, I would say, of destruction together. This is the power, destructive power of Sri Ganesh. Is the destructive power of Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesha. It is the destructive power of the mother. Is the destructive power of the Ganesha, Shivas is the Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesha, and four of these are Bhairava and Hanumana, Kartikeya and Ganesha. And Ganesha. Also the powers of Sadashiva and of the Adishakti. All the destructive powers of all the incarnations are Ekadasha. Now the last but not the least is the destructive power of Hiranyagarbha, which is the collective Brahmadeva. And this power, when it acts, every atom explodes, the whole atomic energy goes into a destructive power. So thus, the complete total destructive power is Ekadasha Rudra. It's extremely powerful, explosive, but it's not blind. It's very discriminating and extremely delicately woven. It avoids all the good points and attacks the wrong things. Avoids. And it hits at the right time, at the right point, direct, without hitting anything that is good in between. Now the glance of Ekadasha Rudra falls upon someone, say, for example, and there is something in between which is divine or which is a positive thing. It penetrates through positive without harming the positive and hits the negative. It cools down somebody and burns another.
See,
not freezing, it doesn't freeze, it cools down. So that is how it works with such care and such delicacy. And it is tremendously sharp also. And it's very painful. It's not like cutting the neck in one shot. It goes on slowly, slowly. All the horrible tortures that you have learnt or heard about are expressions of Ekadasha only. For example, take the case of cancer. In the cancer thing, the nose is removed, the tongues are removed, and the gullet is removed, and everything goes on one after, being removed with terrible pain, you see. Take leprosy, for example. The lepers cannot feel their fingers. They cannot feel it. So any rat or anything eats their finger, they can't feel it, so they start losing their fingers. That is how Ekadasha eats up people. Devours. But this wrathfulness of the father can be very gentle and could be very
sweet when it comes to his own children. The story is about the mother. Once she got very angry, the primordial mother, and she was so angry she wanted to destroy the whole world with her Ekadash power, and she tried to destroy the whole world. When she went into that mood, the father himself felt that she is being a bit too much angry. So when she started destroying and she was going right and left, he didn't know what to do. So he took her child, that means representing Sahajyogi, you can say, representing Christ, or representing anyone of these great children of hers, that he put the child under her feet. So when she was stamping, suddenly she saw her own child under her feet, and she had such a big tongue came out, she just stopped balancing. But this has happened only once. So after the Ekadashi Rudra, ultimately the complete destruction comes through the anger of Sadashiva, when the final, total destruction takes place. So thus we have seen how Ekadashi Rudra acts, and how Sahajyogis have to become themselves Ekadashi Rudra. Now to develop this power, one has to develop a tremendous power of detachment. Power of detachment. Detachment from negative. For example, negativity can come from very near people like brother, mother, sister, could come from friends, could come from relatives. It could come from a country, it could come from your political ideas, economic ideas, anything like that. Any misidentification can destroy your power of Ekadashi. So it is not only sufficient to say that I am surrendered to Sahajyoga and I am a Sahajyogi, but you must know mentally also what is Sahajyoga, so that intelligently you understand what is Sahajyoga. Because in the West especially, people are over-intelligent, and if the light of Sahajyoga doesn't enter into their intelligence, you can never overcome your attachments. That doesn't mean you talk too much about Sahajyoga or you give lectures on that, but mentally you should also understand what is Sahajyoga. Today is a special day when it has been asked that we should have Ekadashi Rudra Puja, and is for all kinds of false religious sects and false gurus and false religions, which are followed in the name of God, or any religion that does not say about self-realization and does not achieve self-realization and does not get connected with God is false. So any such thing that is just fake and talks of God but has no connection with God cannot be a true religion. Of course, it gives a balance to people, but in giving that balance, if people live on that money and try to enjoy a wealth out of that money, then it is not even at the very lower level is religion. Like a balance, you see. Religion has to give you a balance to begin with. But in that balancing, when they tell you, you have to be balanced, but give me money for that. You must give me money, give all your purse, give you everything. Then that cannot be balanced. It does not even have a slightest thing or the blessings of God. Or any religion that makes you bow to anybody else but the incarnation is no religion. That's another one.
which is absolutely false. The real religion will give you a balance and will always talk about the asset. But they will not ask for money or make one man something great as venerated. Thus, we should learn to discriminate between falsehood, negative things, and real things. Once you develop that discrimination through vibratory awareness or through your intelligence, you are in the control of yourself. And then you become that power of Ekadasha. When you establish your maturity. Today I bless you all that you all become the power of Ekadasha Rudra. And you develop that sincerity which takes you to that state. May God bless you.